Well, welcome to a special episode of the Twin City Check-In Show. We're breaking our rules a tad bit by having somebody not in Twin City, but we are very excited to have joining us today Bishop Lawson Bryan, the Bishop of the South Georgia Annual Conference. Bishop Bryan, how are you doing?
I am doing well. Thank you for the opportunity to be here, and I want to greet everyone who is joining us today, and I'm grateful for this opportunity.
Well, what have you been up to? Your schedule has changed a lot. In May, we were supposed to have General Conference, and you're going to be gone there, and you'd be getting ready for Annual Conference happening in June, but your whole schedule, like all of our lives, has been turned upside down. How have you been?
For years, we have known what we thought our schedule was, and I've certainly been planning it, and now a number of the things that were on my calendar have lines drawn through them because they're not going to happen that way. So like everybody else, I've been in a constant state of adjustment. Someone recently said to me, "What I sent to you was true for 30 minutes, but then it changed after that." I feel like we're all somewhat living that, and we are adapting every day and adjusting to things we never imagined. But one of the things I've discovered is I feel connected to everybody because we're all going through this together. So that's what I do every day is I say, okay, what's different today from what I thought it was going to be? And I actually ask, what's the next step we need to take? One step at a time.
That's great. And it's funny, we've been further apart, but also we've been closer together in some ways. I know our church has been blessed through the South Georgia Conference. We don't have online giving, but the South Georgia Conference has graciously resourced us with an online giving platform that my family has used. We had several families in our church use. We have an excellent webinars that you participated in, and Allison Lindsay has been leading. And y'all have done a wonderful job resourcing us. So we're in this weird time where we've never been more distant physically, even with the people in our own community. At the same time, we're using the technology of webinars or phone calls and really reaching out to each other.
Absolutely. That's been fascinating to see something that on the one hand is so disruptive, but on the other hand, as you said, we're connecting in ways we haven't done before. And one week just recently, on 4 days of that week, I was on a call with 90 of our clergy one day, another 90 the next day, 60 the next day, 70 the next day. I'm loving this. And I'm also thankful to our laity and the way they're continuing to support their church too.
And every now and then while we're preaching, somebody's phone will ring. And when you're in a meeting with 90 people on Zoom, that also happens too. We occasionally still have phones ringing. So some things have changed and some things haven't changed at all. Hey, I want to ask you, I know you're an avid exerciser. You like to get out and walk. Has the coronavirus impacted you being able to get out and do your exercising, you and your wife?
I am very fortunate that my beautiful wife and wonderful wife, Cheryl, is kind of my coach also. She knows I need exercise. And so she, because she gets up and gets out early in the morning, and because I love walking with her, we still do 3 to 4 miles a day, most every day. And that really does help too, I would have to say.
So you're going to come out of the quarantine even more muscular and strong and ready to do ministry for many more. We're not going to let you retire if you get in too good of a shape.
I think I'll come out of it okay physically, but I would have to say I have added some pounds because all the Zoom meetings I'm on are at home, and I love the kitchen. I love the refrigerator. I like good food, and I like taking my time too. I don't like to rush through meals because I see that as a part of ministry. So I've certainly been well fed by Cheryl's good cooking.
Speaking of meals, you led our whole conference in a love feast. We had a wonderful service two Sundays ago, I believe.
Yeah, that's right.
That was really neat. But you've also been, back in the saddle putting together worship services because not all churches have the ability to stream or put services up. And so you've been coming up with worship services every week. How has it been getting back in the flow?
That's been wonderful because I've always felt that worship is the center and core of what we do. Everything that we do feeds into worship, and everything that we're going to do grows out of worship. And so I never feel more alive than when I'm in a worship experience. And yet with our conference, we've been able to feature individuals and groups from all over the conference. So on Easter Sunday, we had greetings brought in Korean, Spanish, African-Americans helped lead the congregation, as well as Caucasians. And I just exhilarated in that to see the diversity of South Georgia being celebrated on Easter.
Yeah, and if you want to watch those services, they usually stream before our services. So if you want to get double dip and get two church services on Sunday, you can do that on Facebook Live on the South Georgia Conference page.
Thank you. And they're on our conference website, and they're archived there. You can see all of them. And I'm grateful to the church members and Allison, Lindsay, and Kelly Robertson, who actually put that together, and I'm glad to have a part.
Well, I just appreciate you being our warm-up service before we get into our service.
Well, I think your church service deserves it, and I want to do all I can to get people ready for the real preacher. And by the way, the best preaching is done by local preachers who know their congregation, know their situation. No guest can come close to what the local preacher does. So I really do thank you for that.
Absolutely. There's better preachers out there than me, but we have such a great competitive angle of speaking life into our specific community.
Exactly.
So I thank you for doing that into the South Georgia Conference and reminding us that we have that. Well, Bishop Brian, you are a very busy person. We want to honor your time. Is there anything before you go that you would like to say to the people in Twin City?
I just would like to say to the folks in Twin City how grateful I am that you are the church right there in your community. There's nobody else who can mean and be and do what you mean and be and do to that area. Thank you for representing the gospel of Christ and the South Georgia Conference. And remember Ephesians 2:5, God has made us alive together in Christ. And we are in some ways more together now, though we're physically separated. But I'm looking forward to the day when we'll also be physically back with each other, but only when we can do it in safety. So thank you for your patience and for your encouragement and for continuing to be the church, no matter what season we're in. God bless you for that.
Well, Bishop Brian, thank you so much for joining us. My wife, Brandy, and we keep you in our prayers, and we just thank you for your leadership and taking time to be with us today.
Thank you. God bless everyone.